Should you buy an electric vehicle if you live where below freezing and the winter is the standard? Simple Car Guy here, and today we will talk about the effects of cold weather on EVs, what to expect and to look for when buying one yourself, as well as my personal experience with this BMW i3 and Chicago winters. Let's get to it. Winter and cold weather bring a lot of extra challenges for drivers no matter what they drive. But with a growing popularity of EVs, what are the differences between driving an internal combustion engine vehicle and an electric one? Well, just like any other vehicle, you have to pay attention to ice and snow on the roads, snowed in or stuck cars, but with EVs, you also have to worry about the range. Range anxiety is already a common issue when looking at an electric vehicle, but it gets much more complicated in the winter. Since everything in the EV runs off of the high voltage battery, everything affects the range as well. For example, running the cabin heater or seat warmers or even the defroster will take away the range. Not only that, the charging speeds will also reduce if the battery is not at its optimal temperature, as some of the energy will have to be used to condition the battery. Now, how do you know if your battery is not at the right temperature? Well, since the battery cannot deliver full power in extreme conditions, your power will be decreased as well. On my BMW i3, it is indicated in the e-power gauge, and it may take 15 to 20 minutes of driving before you get full performance. So, is that it? Do EVs suck in the winter? Well, not exactly. There are a few things we can do to help here. First, you want to find a car that has a battery heater and a heat pump. That's the important part. A heat pump is a more efficient heating system that can significantly improve cabin heating, but it is model specific. My BMW i3 does not have a heat pump built in since it has a range extender option and there just wouldn't be enough room for both. But if you were to go for the electric only version of the BMW i3, then those came with a heat pump as standard in US. On some cars, a heat pump is standard, on some cars it's an option, but there are some that only offer resistive heating, such as the Chevy Bolt and the Mustang Mach-E. So you definitely want to make sure you get the right options. The battery heater is a much more common standard feature and allows you to precondition the battery before driving. This is an excellent way to have your car ready to go in the morning. But of course, you have to know when you will be leaving every day. The car will usually precondition the cabin at the same time, so the battery is not wasted heating up the cabin while you're driving. Maintaining the battery and cabin temperature is a lot more efficient than starting from scratch. One thing to note is that preconditioning the battery will use a good amount of energy. I ran an experiment to see how much energy my BMW i3 would actually use to do this, and here are the results. Okay, so as we can see, we have used 3.9 kilowatt hours since plugging this car in and putting it to precondition. This is at about 22 degrees Fahrenheit. That's a lot of power. I'm really surprised. I was expecting about maybe 2 kilowatts, something like that. But yeah, the car is plugged in. So now we can unplug it and then we'll see what the gasometer shows us. Let's do it. All right, the beautiful thing is that in the car right now, it feels very warm. It's probably like good 60 something degrees. So that's very nice. And as you can see just over there, our range went from 47 miles or so to 68, which is pretty impressive for this type of weather, right? And more importantly, we have full power. So the car is preconditioned, the battery is warmed up and ready to perform fully and give us the full range. And of course, I feel warm here as well, so I don't have to use the heat. I can probably just run the seat warmers or something like that. I can even put it in Eco Pro Plus, which will give us 68 miles with the heater running in the Eco Pro Plus mode. So it's not gonna really heat up the cabin, but it's gonna keep it more or less the same temperature. As you can see, we have used almost 4 kilowatts of energy to precondition the car. That's a lot of energy. That's like a quarter of the battery size almost. Ideally, the car should be plugged into a level 2 charger about 3 hours before departure to allow the battery to slowly warm up. Plugging the car into a 110-volt socket may not be enough to charge the vehicle and precondition at the same time, especially if it's really cold outside, so you will need 220 to do this properly. Lastly, be careful when choosing your car, as some cars have lost their network connection due to 3G networks being discontinued in US, meaning you will not be able to precondition your car from your phone anymore. This is the case with my 2016 BMW i3, so now my only option is to set a schedule from within the car. If I went for a 2017 version of the same car, I would have remote options still available to me, as those cars use 4G network and, well, work just fine. Does this mean getting a newer EV will always be better than getting an older one? Well, not necessarily. Not all newer EVs do better than the older ones. For example, the Mustang Mach-E, which only came out a couple of years ago, has a 30% range loss in the winter, which is worse than an all-electric BMW i3 or the Nissan Leaf. The range drop varies depending on the model or the options like the heat pump we discussed earlier. Some cars do better than others, but you can expect anywhere between 10 to 30% loss of range, but it can be as much as 40% with the heater on full blast. Now let's take a look at some real-world scenarios with my 2016 BMW i3. I have done multiple range tests and I will share some of those results here with you. During the summer, this car gets about 75 miles of electric range on a full charge, and now with the ambient temperature dropping all the way to 35 Fahrenheit and only using the seat warmers, no cabin heater, the car shows 8 less miles of range, which is a decrease of 10%. Turning the cabin heater on and switching to Eco Pro reduces the range by another 10 miles, which means the range is now only 76% of what it was in the summer. We have lost about 24% of range. And now let's go to the extreme. Normally I keep my car in the garage, but I left it outside overnight with temperatures dropping to low 20s. I didn't put it in Eco Pro mode and had the heater on at half capacity. What do you think the range will be now? Well, the range dropped by another 8 miles. This means our 75 mile range car has decreased to 49 miles. That's almost a loss of 35% range between the perfect and the worst case scenario. Leaving the car outside also reduces our performance to only about half. However, if you follow the advice above and precondition the vehicle, we can see that the results are much different. Not only do we have more range, but we also have full power ready to go. Of course, by today's EV standards, this BMW i3 is ancient and has a tiny range to start with. But the principle is the same no matter which EV you buy. The range will decrease by some percentage in the winter. Okay, I know. Some of you have already left comments below complaining that I just hate EVs and I'm trying to scare people off, but I'm not being negative. If I actually didn't like this car, I would have sold it already. This video is more about setting the right expectations for new EV buyers. I would recommend getting an EV that has double the range of your daily commute. You don't want to be caught in a snowstorm traffic jam on an empty battery. If you think the climate where you live might be too harsh for a pure electric, a plug-in hybrid might be a great idea. This is what I've done. This BMW i3 has a range extender and at the very least doubles my range. And of course it can be refueled in under a minute since it only takes 2 gallons. And if you click on this video that just popped up, you can learn 10 things you didn't know about this BMW i3. Thank you guys so much for watching and I'll see you in the next one.